Ka Committee on Women's Empowerment balathung da keing darbar thawan kala dawa bade bentung da ka kunhon tokit balat lut bat ka bomde bandan menta ki officer ke East Gentle Hills halor ga jingsha pen mesau ka president ka CSWO ka Kong Agnes Khashiing ringkat ka polok jengka ka mita sama ka belaja hak fratrik menta ubnai hak sinong so shri East Gentle Hills district menta ka singi ka committee kala khat hajiru ya ki bor penyai ke East Gentle Hills bakentup nadu deputy commissioner uba FM Dob Badu Superintendent of Police Uba Sylvester Nongtinger Nalor kiwe kiwe ki officer ke district Haba kerana bagi lap thai kebor Ke chairman jaka committee Kepada ke MLA na East Shillong Constituency Ke kong M. Ampri Lingdo Kelak thayar ting ya ke jing suki ke jing tukit Halor ke tege jing jang Bada haka juga por kelak pen pau ya ke jing lingo Bahaya ya ke jing tukit ke batmu sendan Ben shim ya ke jing im Jong kita ke arngut Lale tangdo additional deputy commissioner Bada uba SS Imli Uba klempoi satya Sya ke jing khot ke CWE Kalong bakat kum ke jinglap jang ke komiti na ke jingnya tu ki buat distrik ki dan buon ke jingduna man penstet ya ke jingtokit. Kalong bahaduk mentah lak kem ya ke nriungut ki briu bahas sebuah don keti ha ke jingpin mensaw ya ke Kong Agnes bat ke Amita bat ki babun ki lak pelat no. Kedba ki briu bala ilam ya ke tege jing tambor empat yok man kem setia haduk mentah. Ke Kong Amprin ke lak ya tuk ru bak ke komiti ke lak alap ru ya ke jingduna ha ke baidei bak ke jingtokit da ki pulit Hagbaidei bakate ge jingsha thambor khamtam ye ki briu sarkar ki badan haswa kate ge jingsha thambor kanja hadu menta empat simla tokit iki kalong baka komiti ke sengol lingo ru ban tip baka bailut kesan naga menta ban sumari ki arngut ki longkmi la mangtang khat arhaja nuspa tingka marwe bat kataru naga tenat disaster management ke distrik bat ke bampat pelaj hadu menta ke kong amprin lingdo kalong baka komiti kadawa badai ban siu bailut kesan ye ki arngut Katkum kejing betah ke Kashri Meghalaya High Court ke belong sanlak tingkah marwe. Ya kejing tokit lah betah ban pendep hapo ke kaksan sengi ke ban kutno hakini kisingi ban wan. Henry larak biang ban penjelan ya kini kejing tokit syakalai pau tarik mentau benai. Nakal yang ke chairman ke CWE ke lapan pauru ya kini kejing penjelan syuk-syuk ya ke por. Bat ong bakatkum kejing lap jengka komiti. Bat haduk kalai pau tarik om tarai ban lak ban pendep ya kejing tokit. Bat pen pauru kejing lingok bu SP ulakam bakadun kejing duna. Kipulit benle ya kejing tukit li benle wat ya kibas sebuah dan keti. Kekong amprin kalong ru baka komiti kan ra ya kini kejing lap haka darbar kerpang la syai kesengi. Dah kaba on kentu ya lompang ke yang darbar ban ailat ban pesengau ya kini kejing lap komiti. Bat pen pauru ya kejing kemik linti ban yo ya kejing terilang da baro ambil pungut ke MLA.
An inquiry was instituted only at the level of the deputy DC of the district, additional DC of the district. This in itself is concerning us because we believe that life-threatening threat against two prominent women in the state of Meghalaya only takes the attention of a committee headed by an additional DC. We object to that and we have informed and communicated to the DC that we demand as a committee an independent inquiry on the matter. The second observation that is very disturbing is the fact that the arrests made so far do not substantiate the seriousness of this crime against women in a matrilineal state. Six arrests made so far. And we are made to understand, even out of the six, that not all six remain in police custody. We are told by the SP and the DC that main accused suspected by the police remain at large, not to be found, not apprehended, not to be traced. Now, this is a very, very serious lapse. And our committee strongly object to this very casual approach that has been adopted by the district administration on such a serious crime. The third observation we make is that there seems to be a lot of lapses on inquiry and statements taken on different individuals who are linked and who are vitally connected to a proper understanding of the circumstances that led to to the assault of both Agnes Karshie and her friend Amrita Sangma. We have noted these and we have told the DC that it is impossible to believe that key officials who were present in the district prior to the assault on these two women have still not been interrogated and inquired upon. What is more disturbing is that the chairperson of this inquiry instituted by the district did not even attend today's meeting. The additional DC has not even attended and responded. He is the main inquiring officer. We have not been told, though we have asked, who are the members of this inquiry committee. We have still not been informed, but we are awaiting information on that. The third thing that really troubles us as a committee is the fact that the district administration had initially only suggested a compensation of ₹12,700 per victim for expenses of medicines and other requirements by the family. It took a court order. Who has instructed the state government to release 5 lakhs each to each family as compensation for this abuse on them. But we are told that even that is still pending, that the inquiry period has been extended to the 30th of November, and it seems and it looks like even the 30th of November is not going to be sufficient time frame for the committee to actually give its recommendations and findings.